whenever we sat down and thought about it, and obviously we looked for feedback from other entities, other companies that were involved, and some of that feedback came from you guys. We realised that landlords faced some different issues that weren't there just in the homeowners. The legislation is different for a start, and some of the product range that they needed, some of the types of advice that they needed was different. So we thought to ourselves, the best thing to do is sit down and look at this. And to be honest, we're landlords ourselves. We both of the directors have investment portfolios, so we understand some of the pressures that landlords are under from that sense. And what we thought the best thing to do was to design a product specifically around landlords. And a big part of that came off the back of this Section 24, the landlord taxes coming in, that there's going to be so much pressure on landlords going forward that we thought we'd better have a product that just spoke directly to them, as opposed to trying to fit them into a pre-existing product. The process is fairly simple. We have quite a bit of information on our website. So usually what will happen is somebody will have, as opposed to our homeowner websites and negative equity UK, negative equity NI sites, the landlord clients tend to have read most of the information that's on the website. So there's some quite informative stuff on there, some blogs. We will then have a phone call, so a brief chat. And the idea behind that is to find out where the landlord is with their portfolio, what their situation is, what their expectations are, to see is it something that we can actually help them with. So in that initial conversation, whenever we're talking to a homeowner, for example, that initial conversation is usually 10 or 15 minutes. And at the end of that, they're making a decision either to come and see us or to pay us for a review, or they're making a decision to do something fairly quickly. With landlord clients, it tends not to be like that. It tends to be at least two or three conversations. So they come, they ask some questions. We try and find out, you know, what their level of motivation to do something is, where they actually are, what the aspiration is at the end of it, how they would like it to look if you give them a perfect scenario. But that conversation tends to take place over two or three times, not just once. And in most cases, there'll be a fairly in-depth meeting before the review to discuss the portfolio and different aspects of it more, because it's trying to get under the skin of it. Sometimes it can be very difficult for a landlord to say, well, this just isn't working. It tends to take a couple of conversations to tease that information out. Then we carry, as I say, if they were commissioned to, if we think we can do something, we carry out a review. And then at the end of that review, we come back. And a thing that we can find in a lot of cases is, which is a big part of that review, should the client even be where they are in the first place? You know, is the security right? Was everything done correctly in the first instance? Because we find quite a lot of issues in there. There was some crazy lending between 04 and sort of 08. So even though it was non-regulated, it's buy-let stuff, there's still redress there. So we look backwards, try and get a picture of where the landlord is now, and then present our findings, and there will be a route forward for that client. It depends whether they want to take it or not. And then at that stage, we'll act under instruction. We are used to working with banks day and daily, whereas even experienced landlords in some cases aren't, and we just take that pressure off. As soon as we take somebody on as a client, we'll write to the bank, we'll explain to them, this is, we're acting for them now, can you please, all correspondence, all phone calls to come to us. The difference between us and what somebody can do for themselves is our relationships, is our experiences. We have cases running currently at this moment in time. I think we're representing somewhere close to 500 different clients. So we have cases running with every lender, every conceivable lender in the UK. We either have them running or we have had them running. So we'll have some sort of contact with that lender before, and it's usually fairly positive contact, believe it or not. We usually have quite a good relationship with, so somebody coming on with us as a client, we just take all that pressure away from them, and that's really what they're paying us for.